All right, I'm Craig. Behind the camera is Kelly, and there's Dima over there. We did Coca-Cola Bottling Company Consolidated. It's a mouthful. CCBCC is the largest Coke distributor in the U.S., and they are based out of Charlotte, North Carolina. Coca-Cola Company is a beverage company, not just a soda company. CCBCC is buying up all of the Coca-Cola Company's distribution centers that they're getting rid of, because Coca-Cola Company is looking to go to just a marketing brand. Each distributor acts separately and independently from each other, and the turnover rate for Coca-Cola CCBCC is low everywhere except for the low skill labor positions. CCBCC utilizes several different production strategies in order to increase profitability and reduce cost across the board. CCBCC uses a price limiting technique that sacrifices short-term revenue in order to increase customer loyalty. They will sell products at a loss to a company such as Walmart in order to maintain business with them in the future and cut competitors out of the market. CCBCC is constantly trying to improve its human relations with people inside the company through a stewardship program called Charitable Choice, where they donate and help families of employees work through daily life. And this helps employees stay focused on the job at hand at Coca-Cola.
Forces driving change at Coca-Cola include a shift in consumer trends, innovation, competition, and profit maximization. Americans' tastes in food and beverages are rapidly changing. Millennials are leading the charge to move from fast food and prepackaged goods towards more healthier, fresher options. A 2015 consumption habits poll showed that 62% of Americans were avoiding carbonated beverages altogether. The tobacco industry experienced similar change in consumer behavior when, after years of smoking, consumers were faced with major health questions. The smoking rate dropped from 40% to 16% from 1970 to 2015. The gradual increase in those avoiding carbonated beverages is similar to what the tobacco industry experienced and is indicative of a cultural shift rather than simply a fad of the time. Now, innovation. The only thing constant in life is change. A company must be able to achieve growth in an ever-changing market. And in order to do so, said company should be able to systematically innovate and deliver new products or services. The ability to innovate in an ever-changing market can be a determinant of success or failure of an organization. A company can be innovative in many ways, but said innovation must create value for the company and demand in the consumer. Now, competition. Currently, Pepsi Company is gaining steam on Coca-Cola's market share. They recently bumped Diet Coke out of the number two most recognized brand spot. In order to combat this threat of competition, Coke Consolidated should consider seeking out new emerging markets and growth industries, as well as continuing to expand their merchandising market. Similar interests are shared between Coke and Pepsi. It would be beneficial to find ways to differentiate through product innovation and sustainable practices. And finally, profit maximization. This is typically the aim and purpose of all for-profit corporations in existence, and Coke Consolidated is no different. However, it is different in that profit maximization is a force that is driving change within the company. The Coca-Cola mission plainly states that management's primary objective is to maximize shareholder value over time. In order to achieve this, all facets of Coca-Cola must create value for the average consumer and retail customer. Now, moving on to key success factors. Brand loyalty is a huge factor for success for Coca-Cola, Coke Consolidated, and everything associated with the Coca-Cola brand. This brand is iconic and globally recognized, and it has exemplified what brand loyalty means throughout its 125 years of inception. Many consumers of carbonated beverages only buy a particular brand, myself included. They really purchase from another competitor, such as Pepsi or RC Cola. Now, according to statistical research, an astounding 1.9 billion Coca-Cola products are sold around the world daily. Coca-Cola has been able to retain the status of the most recognized brand in the world by maintaining a connection with its consumers, being flexible in a changing environment, product innovation, and stewardship. Now, the Coca-Cola system is often used to describe the network of companies engaged in the company's value chain. It is a franchise partnership with the bottling companies that has allowed the brand to explode into iconic status. CCBCC is the largest independent marketer, producer, and distributor of the Coca-Cola Company products in the United States, with franchise territory in 13 states. CCBCC utilizes an extensive sales and delivery force to market and distribute soft drinks to retail customers and consumers. Currently, CCBCC is acquiring manufacturing facilities in order to expand its franchise distribution territory. Now, a customer-centric focus is something that Coke Consolidated embodies. This is when the company utilizes the approach to provide more than just good products and services. Customer-centric approach focuses on creating a positive experience for the customer pre-sale, at the point of sale, and as well as post-sale. And again, Coke embodies this essence right from the start. Their mission is to refresh the world, inspire moments of optimism and happiness, and to create value and to make a difference. Customer preference is at the core of CCBCC's business. They express a passion for the consumer through its product and services. CCBCC desires to partner with customers to deliver mutually beneficial results, striving to build long-term value for its customers. And finally, system integration is a key success factor for Coke Consolidated. In order to better gauge demand, manage sales volumes, and maintain customer service levels, daily communication is imperative. In an effort to better serve its sales team and customers, CCBCC created Marketplace. The mobile application was designed to facilitate customer engagement and allow field sales personnel to create customized sales proposals from anywhere. Leveraging the proper tools to help manage sales swings, the release of new products, and boost customer service is critical to growth and maintaining a competitive advantage.
I'll talk about SWOT analysis, and I'd like to start with strengths. And the biggest strengths we've identified is that they're the biggest independent Coca-Cola bottler, and they have a large variety of products. Let's move on to weaknesses, and the biggest weaknesses we think they have are that their prices are fixed by Coca-Cola Company, and that they have low capacity, which does not allow them to keep up with their demand. Let's move on to opportunities, and the biggest opportunities we see are the expansion outside the southeastern region, and increasing capacity, which does not allow them currently to keep up with their demand. The biggest threat that Coke Consolidated has are changes of taste and preferences of consumers and increasing the cost of raw materials. Now we'll move on to financials, and we've gathered information for the past few years. We have here the most important ratios that we think will help us to provide an analysis. Overall, we think that their financials are weaker than the industry average, because, for example, industry average net profit margin is 11%, and we could see it's much lower for Coke Consolidated. The same we could say about ROE, which is average for the industry at about 28.6%, and it's much lower for CCBCC. We think the weakness is connected to their low net income, and they have low net income due to their high operating costs. For example, the costs grew from $566 million to over $1 billion in the past few years. We've identified a difference in the trends in 2015, and we think that the reason for this is their expansion into new regions and a lot of acquisitions at the end of 2014 and at the year of 2015. I'll talk about strategic concerns, and the first concern we have is environmental issues, and we think this problem is really trending nowadays because younger generation cares about the environment a lot, and we think it could really hurt Coke Consolidated's demand, and they should be aware of this problem. The next issue we have is inability of suppliers to keep up with demand, and they have expanded into new territories recently, which means their demand is going to be growing, and it has been growing recently. So they have to try to solve this issue in order to be able to serve every customer they can. The next issue we have is high turnover of low-skilled labor workers, and we think that those workers are not really satisfied in their position because they have addressed a lot of concerns to management, and it looks like they have not been heard. So just because changes have not been made, they left the organization, and it could really hurt the image of the organization. And we also all know that it's much costly to acquire a new worker than to keep the worker that we already have. And Kelly will talk about the rest of the concerns.
So next we have maintaining brand status and relevance. Coca-Cola, we know, is an iconic global brand, but right now it's becoming victim to changing consumer preferences. Consumption trends have long been moving in new, healthier directions, and this shift in the market is indicative of a cultural shift in customer preferences rather than just a fad. Now, to further complicate matters, Coke has not introduced a new product line of growth to combat the decline in sales that they've been experiencing. Now, while Coca-Cola may always be the leading brand of cola in the soft drink industry, it is the industry itself is likely to decline over the next 20 years, and Coca-Cola will need to shift its strategic focus in order to maintain that coveted, most recognized brand in the world status. And finally, we have lack of internal support. CCBCC is currently experiencing a few issues due in part to their faster than expected growth with rapid acquisition of old Coca-Cola company bottlers. As a result, CCBCC is feeling the heat of not having adequate internal support. Proper organizational support is crucial to the success of any company. Currently, support functions are centralized, and while it does have many advantages to have centralized support functions, being able to decentralize some aspects does allow for adaptability and autonomy while getting a better understanding of what the needs of the local customer are.
Hey guys, so we have three recommendations for CCBCC. The first is a healthier, more sustainable Coca-Cola for generations to come. The second is a leadership pipeline, developing leaders at every single level. And third is personal development to attract millennials. A healthier, sustainable Coca-Cola is what Coca-Cola needs to survive past this maturing industry, and so that they don't die out in the next 20 years and become an irrelevant number one brand in the world. They need to shift their strategic focus to environmental and sustainability issues, such as the plastics and cardboard and aluminum that they use in their products. And they need to look into making those more recyclable. We need to focus shift to product innovation and cultivating strategic alliances. So innovating our products to be more sustainable will, first of all, cultivate strategic alliances, because people will want to work with us if we're working with the world. And second of all, focus shift. Second of all, that will make millennials more likely to buy our products because they see that we also care about the world. Third thing is national commitment. We need everyone to know via a major marketing campaign that we are going for a healthier products and better products for the world. This campaign would showcase the brand's commitment to doing so. And we also need to create a task force to determine the most cost-effective, environmentally sustainable practices for CCBCC. We need to figure out how to do these problem-solving. All right. We need to create a task force to determine the most cost-effective, environmentally sustainable practices for CCBCC.
Our next recommendation deals with developing a leadership pipeline and encouraging leaders at every level of the organization. According to a Deloitte University Press Human Capital Trends report, a shortage of leaders is one of the biggest impediments to an organization's growth, to the point that organizations are willing to spend millions of dollars cultivating its personnel through leadership development opportunities. And the pace of business has changed. Decisions have to be made much more quickly and at different levels of the organization. It's critical for companies to have confidence in an employee's leadership skills and abilities. Currently, senior Coke executives participate in a six-week globetrotting program that is aimed at sharpening their management leadership skills. The Coke Leadership Academy, launched in 2013, aims to expose participants to every aspect of the business. So what we are recommending is a tiered leadership development program that creates a leadership pipeline with a efficient and effective leaders throughout the entire organization. Starting with upper level management, this program would be similar to what senior execs are experiencing in their Learning Academy right now. 2 weeks visiting various Coca-Cola bottlers, both in and outside of their respective territories. The goal would be to gain a better understanding of how bottlers are managing operations in different areas of the country while facing different constraints. It also, doing this together as a team and sending the whole management team together would help to create community amongst the team and a cohesive bond amongst all of the members. Next, to engage middle management levels, we would recommend co-consider possibly Dale Carnegie training. Dale Carnegie training, it helps you to master the human relations skills that are in such high demand in today's business environment. Dale Carnegie also offers corporate solutions that strategically map out training programs that will align with the organization's visions and goals, and offers programs as well in change management, customer service, communications, employee engagement, executive training, organizational development, and presentation effectiveness, and sales. Now, to engage the low-skill labor workforce in the leadership pipeline, we would recommend soft skills development. Soft skills, refer to skills such as collaboration, problem solving, conflict resolution, and communication. Now, according to an ADECO staffing survey, 44% of executives say that a lack of soft skills was the biggest proficiency gap that they saw in the U.S. workforce. The development of these skills have become such an important aspect of doing business today that high schools are implementing curriculum into their schools to teach students soft skills before they enter the workforce. Now, soft skill development does not have to be a costly endeavor or a time-consuming one for that matter, but the results can be a more retainable and ultimately stronger workforce. In addition to soft skill development being included in new hire training, there are many everyday opportunities to teach employees soft skills, such as experiential learning experiences, company mentorship programs for new employees, situation simulators, and team building exercises.
The third and last recommendation is personal development program to attract millennials to the company. And to describe millennials a little bit, they're adaptable, entrepreneurial, team-oriented, and very creative. And they're looking for employers who will actually seek to enhance these characteristics. We suggest that Co-Consolidated should implement a development program that will help to attract these new employees and will always train them and just make it more interesting for new employees to come to the company. From a few graphs here, we could see that millennials prefer the companies that have good opportunities for growth and that have good development and training program. So we suggest that Co-Consolidated should have different types of training, like in-class training every day, going to some events with motivational and inspirational speakers, or just working in the team environment together and work on some case under mentorship. So the next characteristic of millennials is that they like the feedback in real time instead of just getting the old school report. And we think that it would be pretty beneficial for Co-Consolidated to assign a mentor to a group of around 5 or 8 employees that could always give them the right directions and compliment their work if it was done correctly, etc. So another feature that we think would be really productive is implement a point system into this training. For example, we've got a few teams that work separately on different projects, but they can't undergo the same training. So the teams would get points for successful completion of the test or successful completion of the project, and whichever team gets the biggest amount of points could see either bigger bonus or better opportunities for promotion. So also, to keep millennials in the company, we think it would be really beneficial for the company to create an environment for them that they would like, and just going every day to work that would enjoy instead of dragging their bags to work at night and coming back home at 5. So we suggest a series of perks that would be really beneficial to millennials. For example, free food or like resting area, like you could see on the picture, napping rooms like Google has, we could see it from their example, or also a gym that they could go to during their lunch break and lift some weights for 15-20 minutes and distract a little bit. So our team truly believes that with the brand name and resources Co-Consolidated has, they could create this type of environment for millennials, and it could be a dream job for every young graduate out there.